Welcome back to my channel, Being a Programmer. I am Rajashree and today we have to see how to write a test scenarios for any login page. So without any further ado, let's quickly get started. So first of all, look at here. We take an example of our Gmail account, which is Gmail login page for these test scenarios. So here is your Gmail login page in front of you. So here you have to provide email or phone number, then click on next button, then you have to provide a password, and then you log in successfully when you provide correct credentials or valid credentials. So we have to test, or we have to write a test scenarios for this login page. So without any further ado, let's back to our video. So look at here, I take a screenshot of our Google login page. So our first test scenario is here. Verify the login screen will appear after clicking on login page or login website. We have to verify. Here is our website. We search Google Gmail login, new login or new sign in. Just a second. We search Gmail new sign in, and this website is in front of us, account.google.com for your login. And when I click on this website, we have to need this login page for our Gmail account. So we have to verify this is happening when we click on our website. We have to navigate on our Gmail login page or not. So this is our first test scenario is here. Then our second test scenario, verify the login related element and field are present on login page or not. We have to verify login related element, that means your title, for which kind of login is here, so that title is available in front of you. Then the text box in which you have to mention the email or phone number, that is your username. Then forgot email option, create account, next option, then password field is available or not. All your login related elements are available or not, we have to verify that also. So this is our second test scenario. Then another test scenario is verify the login page title. We have to verify the login page title. So look at here, is the sign in title is in front of you. So sign in or login are both similar. So this type of title is available in your login page or not. So we have to verify that also. Then our next test scenario, which is so our next test scenario is after the user login page is open, the cursor should remain in email or phone text box by default or not. So come back to our website. When we search Gmail login, after that we click on that particular website, and then we have to navigate to this login form or login page. And when we open this login page, then the cursor is available in your email or phone field by default or not. So look at here. Here is the option available, or cursor is by default in this field. Email or phone field is available by default. So for that, our test case is successful or pass. But some login pages are that type, in which your cursor are not by default in email or phone or username field. So what type of login page you want to test depends on that. So we have to verify that also. Then our next test scenario is verify after click on next button, your password field is disabled or not. So look at here, when we provide email or phone in this text box, Then we click on this next button, and when we click on this next button, we navigate to password field or not. We have to verify that, and that's why we write a test scenario for that field also. Then our next test scenario is verify the user will able to log in their account with correct credentials. So look at here, when we provide a valid credential, valid email or phone number, then valid password, and then when we click on login button, we successfully log in to our Gmail account or not. So we have to verify that, and that's why we write a test scenario for that. Then our next test scenario is verify that the user will get into their dashboard screen after login in with correct credentials. And when user provide a valid credential, after providing valid credentials, we log in to our Gmail account, then we navigate to our dashboard screen of Gmail or not. So we have to verify that also. So these are test scenarios. Then our next test scenario, which is just a second. Verify that the user can log in by entering valid credentials and clicking on login button. So look at here, when we provide a valid email ID and then we click on next button, so we have to verify this test scenario also. When we click on next button, we have to verify to our password field or not. So just few seconds for processing. So look at here, here is the password field in front of you, and when I provide a password, then when I click on this next button, when I click on next button, we have to open the password field in front of us. And after providing password, when I click on next button, I am logging to my Gmail account or not. I have to test that also, and that's why I write a test scenario for that. Then our next test scenario is verify that the user can log in by entering valid credential and clicking on enter key. So look at here, when we provide valid email ID and valid password, and then we have to press enter key, and then we log in to our Gmail account or not. So we have to verify that also. That means next button as well as enter key, both are allow in login to your Gmail account or not. That particular we have to verify. Then our next test scenario is verify whether I icon is added to password field or not. So see here, I icon or show password option is here. When we check this checkbox, then what password we have to enter, that password show here. So suppose we have to want to whatever password is enter, and when we click on this show button or I icon, whatever the login page for particular login page, some login page shows I icon and some login page shows show password option. So when we click on that particular I icon or show password icon, option, then our password is visible or not. So we have to test that also, and that's why we write a test scenario for that. Verify that the user can log in by entering valid credential and clicking on the enter key, and then verify whether I icon is added to password field or not. Then the next test scenario is here, verify that the user can be able to view the password by clicking on that icon. So we can see when we click on show password option, or we check that checkbox, then we can able to view password. So that also we can to check. Then our next test scenario is here. Verify the error message should display after just entering an email address and leaving the password is blank. So look at here, we can enter our email address and then we click on next button. So when we come back to our password field and we cannot fill the password and click on next button, so error will be show or not. So here we show enter a password error, so we have to check that also, we show error message or not when we empty our password field and enter on next button. So we have to check that also. Then our next test scenario is verify the error message should display after just entering password and leaving the email address blank. Then our next test scenario is verify the error message should display after entering invalid credentials. When we provide invalid credentials, that means invalid email address or invalid password, then we show error message or not. So we should also verify that. So that for that we can write a test scenario. Then our next test scenario is verify the error message should display after entering invalid email format. And when we provide invalid email format, that means look at here, we can only provide ABC and we want to enter. So what happened? Couldn't find your Google account. That means @ symbol is compulsory. Then gmail.com option, that domain is compulsory. And when we provide invalid format, then we should show error message or not. So we have to verify that also. So these type of test scenarios for our Gmail login page or any login page. So we see how to write a different test scenarios, and by using that test scenarios we can test our login page of your Gmail. So I hope you understood how what are different test scenarios for this login page, and if you want to see how to write test cases for these test scenarios, then let me know in the comment section. I'll make sure to make the video on that topic also. If you want, please let me know in the comment section. And remember that test scenarios and test cases both are different. For one test scenario, you can write multiple test cases. One or more test cases you have to provide for single test scenario. So test scenario and test cases both are different. I hope you... this video is helpful for you. And if this video is helpful for you, please do like to this video. Also share with your friends. And... do not subscribe. If you do not subscribe to my channel, please subscribe to this channel also and hit the bell icon for such new videos or upcoming videos. And for watching this video, thank you so much. Stay tuned for next video and let me know in the comment section if you want to watch how to write a test cases for these test scenarios or for login page. I'll make sure I make the video on that topic also. Thank you so much.